Hello, Tom.
Hey, man. Hi, Tom again. Today, or right now, I'm gonna take you through all my guitars. Actually, it's not that much to mention, except for it's a comparison horse model guitar. Looks like this. So this is our signature model, or this is my signature model, actually. The thing I changed for this model, because it's based on a Horus model, the thing I changed is I put this Evergrey Clan logo in here. Very nice, in seashell. So do you see it? Do you want me to walk into the light? And what else do you do? Put some kind of Demarcia sounding pickup for the bridge. Like a Jeff Beck, I think. I got a three-way toggle switch, volume knob. It's quite beat up now because this is the first guitar I got. First. Other than that, yeah, I invented these Roman numerics for the neck. So it's 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, 12, and onwards. Yeah, so that's the first one. I can't actually remember the name of it, or the name of the color. T1 stands for Tom, number one.
What did you have there on the third row?
Oh, this thing is an Eddie Van Halen, sort of drop
knob.
D device, but I don't use it anymore. I tried to use it, but it didn't really work that well for me. So, shit. never mind. It didn't work that well. This is the second guitar I got. And as I said, the T1 on the back, on the tape here, is T2. It's Tom guitar number two. It's for our guitar techs to know which guitar is mine and which guitar goes where and into what song. Since, you know, we have a lot of guitar changes during a set. This is just to protect it from my belt. I got a...
Or something else?
Or yeah. When I'm happy, it's from something else. I actually got, I think we have pictures on the webpage where this is totally, you know, brand new. And I know they put tape on this and sprayed it afterwards. So it's pretty much the same guitar as this one. Actually, I think it's exactly the same, except for, you see, I don't have any dots at all on the neck. And I found that to be really, really hard. So I at least had to put some dots on the 15th, 17th, 19th, 21st, and 24th fret. This is 27th fret guitar. It's not that you play this 27th fret that much, but it's very, very convenient when you want to play the 24th or the 22nd fret. It's very easy and very convenient to get in here and do like this. Yeah, so yeah, it's the same pickup. Everything else is the same.
But different.
This is a much heavier guitar. This is the first maple neck guitar we got. It's T5. Very nice. It's got some gold mechanics on here, machine heads. Other than that, it's exactly the same. Very nice maple fretboard. The color of it is, I don't know if you can see, it's quite dark. I think this one is like purple or green or something. I don't know. Good looking. You got Goto machine heads as well. I forgot to mention that before. Goto. And it's a Schaller R2 is the bridge. Here's my fourth guitar. See? T4. This is some kind of, I don't know the color. It's kind of reddish. Same maple board. Which makes it a bit more sort of harder to play. It feels like it's a thicker neck, but it's not. And here's the T3 guitar. The Recreation Day guitar. Some kind of purple, underneath here. Really got torn up due to a lot of touring. See, this is the marks, the belt.
From when you're happy?
See, from when I'm happy. This is from when I'm happy. This is from where I'm, you know, when the belt is. I don't know if I showed you these yesterday. So this is the belt pack we use for the Shure wireless system. Some of my other straps from Straps and Stuff. That's my daughter again. One is the one with chains again, and this is one with the Evergrade logo on it as well. In metal. Metal, right there. And here's another one with smaller chains. Like that. That's about it, basically. I used the Behringer MIDI foot controller, FCB1010. That's about it, really. We use this guitar case, or our guitar guy.